What's up guys, Fishcool back here with another exciting video. In today's video, I have a pretty awesome video set up for you guys. I'm gonna be talking about how this 53-gallon reef tank behind me is gonna be transformed into, dare I say it, a mushroom-dominated reef tank. Now, I know to most of you this sounds pretty weird because it's not really a thing in the hobby. This isn't a zoanthid reef tank, this isn't an SBS-dominated reef tank. This is a mushroom reef tank. Now, there's a lot I have to do before I can actually make the transition. Right now, I actually have been purchasing a lot of mushrooms lately with this idea in mind. So I basically need to start getting rid of some of my other coral. Luckily, I have a couple of LFS around me that should be able to take off some of that coral off my hands and hopefully give me some mushrooms for it, which is what I'm hoping. And if I can do that, then we can be all set up and ready to go to hopefully pick up some more mushrooms and turn this into a mushroom-dominated reef tank. Now, one of the things I really need to think about now that I'm going mushroom-dominated is I need to definitely fix this aquascape. And here's what I mean. So right now what we have, the aquascape going, is a branch style over on the left side, and then on the right side we kind of have a more flat style. This branch unfortunately has to go. I like this branch a lot because it's really awesome for a lot of my euphilia that I have to branch off of that single branch that there is. However, with no euphilia in the tank anymore, which is gonna hurt to be honest, with no euphilia in here anymore, it's time for that branch to go and hopefully fill in a new aquascape there. So let's head up to my room and let's research some aquascapes that I might be looking at for this reef tank. All right, so I'm here on my computer. We're gonna look at a couple different rockscapes and what I could be looking at for this, and what I could be looking at for this mushroom-dominated reef tank. Now, a really good thing that I definitely recommend you guys think about doing is whenever you're looking for reefscape ideas, just search it up on the internet and you can come up with a lot of cool ideas from there or some of the reef to reef forms. All right, so I'm just gonna scroll through picture by picture and tell you a little bit of what I'm looking for and what I'm not. Remember, we want a flat sort of structure, not a lot of bumpiness or places that we can't mount mushrooms. So this is a cool idea. However, you could probably only pull it off with branching corals because it's very low in height. This is another cool one, but you'd have a lot of dead space under here where you couldn't really mount mushrooms, so it wouldn't work as well. This is actually really cool, and I like this one a lot because you have a lot of different branches where you could put stuff. So it's still branchy while still having that flat look. As you can see, all the things leading up to the center, you still get that flat look and then a lot of space to mount around that. That's definitely a cool idea that I check out. I'm seeing a lot of the island looks, and they're definitely appealing to me. Because you always just have that one island out there. I don't know if I could pull it off with a mushroom-dominated reef tank, but it's definitely something to think about. This is another cool one, but you can see you have all that dead space under here, and even in this tank, they didn't put anything below that, so it's just kind of a dead area when you're looking at the tank, so it's not appealing to the eye. There's just too much roundness here, no jagged edges, so that doesn't look that good. Here's the islandscape again that I'm definitely appealed to. Not sure if I can pull it off, especially in a Red Sea reefer, because you know they're definitely a little bit less wider than most reef tanks. This is a cool one. You do have this little bit of overcast in the middle where you would have some dead space, but around that I like it a lot. This one would be cool, but you couldn't pull it off with mushrooms, I don't think. This one, I like this one a lot. You don't lose that much space, I don't think. You'd lose probably some of these side areas around here, but I think you could probably pull that off pretty well. And there's not too bad of an overhang. If you angle the light forwards a little bit and then angle it so it's going back, that could definitely give you a possibility right there. So that's a cool idea to keep in mind. This is a cool idea. This is not much of a scape. But you get the idea of what I'm looking for, is just that coming forward, all of the rocks coming at a forward angle. I like this one a lot for a couple reasons. So as you can see, it's definitely more aimed at a zoanthid-dominated reef tank. And the reason I like this a lot is because you can see here that zoanthids lie very similar to mushrooms. They lie flat. So if you look at ideas for zoa-dominated reef tanks, you could almost always apply those to mushroom-dominated reef tanks. Let's check that out real quick. So you can see here that all of these have that idea of all of it coming forwards and not much bumpiness, because you need all of those to lay flat. This would be a cool idea. This actually has a lot of openness to it. I don't know if I like how much it's centered. It's something to think about though. A lot of these are also nano tanks, and I'm going to be doing this on a much bigger scale, so that's something definitely to think about when you're talking about this. I like this one a lot too. This one has a lot of coming forward, a little bit too many holes for me where I couldn't mount things. But yeah, I think I've gotten a pretty good idea of where I stand with what I want. I'll definitely keep on doing some more research, and I'll let you guys know probably in the next episode what I think about my rockscape and how I'm going to do it. Hopefully next episode we'll have some rock to work with, and hopefully a few more mushrooms. I haven't decided yet if I'm going to try and start from scratch with the rockscape, or if I want to instead kind of work with what I have. The only problem with going from scratch is that I would have to remove all of the mushrooms that have already implanted their foot on the rocks. That's definitely something to think about, because that would be a pain. We'll see where it takes us though, and I'll keep you guys posted. Let's head back downstairs and talk about a few more things with the reef tank. So as you guys saw there, I got a lot of different aquascape ideas in mind right now. Not sure which one I'm going to go with yet. However, I love chances to re-aquascape tanks. It's one of my favorite things to do. I love just putting together something fresh and new and getting a new start, sort of completely on the reef tank.
Boo, what are you doing?
Do you want to say hi to YouTube, Boo? Come here, Boo.
We're going to make you internet famous.
This is my cat, Boo. Say hi. So yeah, that's what I'm thinking in terms of aquascapes right now. The other thing is, you guys know, if I'm going mushroom dominated, we're gonna invest in a couple bounce mushrooms. You guys already know that. I think I have one toxic green bounce mushroom in here, but I think it lost most of its bubbles actually. Like, it was kind of one of those freak accidents where the tank went a downhill slope for like a couple days, and then that mushroom just sort of lost its bubbles and it hasn't really gotten them back yet. If you guys know how to like give mushrooms their bubbles back, leave that in the comments below. I'm super curious to find out, and I could definitely use it for that mushroom in there. The other thing I'm gonna need to come up with is a good system for mushrooms that don't have a foot on anything. So I'm gonna need to come up with a really good system. Probably I'll have to make some kind of DIY container to keep those mushrooms enclosed until they can put their foot on a rock of rubble. That's gonna be a hard thing to come up with, but I think I can do it. It'll just probably take a little bit of time. So yeah, that really wraps it up for this video. This is just gonna be, again, episode one of a series that I am definitely planning to make much longer. Until we get this tank mushroom dominated, and I'm talking top to bottom, full out mushrooms. When I'm not talking those lame redacted green mushrooms, no, we're going high quality, bright mushrooms. You guys can count on that. Right now, you guys have my word, this tank is gonna look pretty awesome. Some other things I wanna address, starting May 22nd, we're gonna be going back to weekly videos. That is when I get off school. So we're gonna be going back to weekly videos. I'll probably start my first upload then, and then from there we'll be weekly, as long as I can keep that up for. Other thing I want to address is, a lot of you guys are asking me if I'm going to be going to Machina 2019. I am not sure just yet. I'm probably going to be leaning on the side of no, sadly, this year. I know that ruins my perfect streak of 4 Machinas in a row, I believe. I'm probably going to be hitting up Aquashell this year. George sent me an invite, and I definitely want to go check it out for the first time. So you guys can either catch me in Chicago or Dallas sometime soon. I'll have those details coming for you guys very soon, I promise. That wraps it up. I hope to see you guys in the next video. Let's try to make this tank completely mushroom dominated. Until next time, I will see you guys later. Fish school out.